2019 and the upcoming years will be a big gift time for single board microcomputers. The once upon a time when people are getting used to with microcontrollers, now they are switching to the microcomputer boards. It is really handy to use, and again it has some kind of basic computer interface, so the working experience is much fast. But if you are looking for the best single board computer with even more oomph than Raspberry Pi 4, so check out in this video. When it comes to single board computers, the Raspberry Pi is the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world. Surely, it is not the most powerful or the most compact or even the cheapest, but its devotees are the legion. It is a legion. It is a legend nowadays. The current version of Raspberry Pi Model 4 is released in June 2019. The top line specs are 1.5 GHz 64-bit quad-core processor, gigabit LAN, Bluetooth 5.0 BLE, and power over Ethernet support with separate PoE hat. For the first time, a Raspberry Pi comes with a choice of 1, 2 or 4GB RAM specification. Sounds like tidy package, right? But retailing for $35, it is perfectly for a variety of DIY project where it's connecting your 3D printer to a network or learning to code or putting together a streaming media hub. Well, the truth of the matter is, where Raspberry Pi blazed with a trail of single board computers, a multitude of imitators followed in the wake, and there's a sizable group of people who do need something more powerful or more compact or even cheaper. Without further ado, here's the selection of best Raspberry Pi alternatives you can buy in 2019, sorted by the price. Number 1. Onion Omega 2 Plus. Onion Omega 2 Plus is a tiny Linux-based development board, so it is working on Linux. Its outstanding characteristics are its price and the size, making it deal for Internet of Things projects. So you are very useful with working with IoT projects here. The operating system will boot immediately after plugging the Omega 2 Plus, reducing the time to get started. Although the single board computer consists pretty much of a tiny chip, it offers a 580 MHz CPU, 128 MB memory and 32 MB storage, USB 2.0, Wi-Fi and a micro SD slot. If you want to expand its functionality, there are several add-on boards and docks you can buy. Nevertheless, Omega 2 Plus memory and processor are proportionally smaller and slower. Moreover, the fact that it does not have any mini HDMI port, so you can add up to a major drawback here, and also, especially when comparing with the cheaper Raspberry Pi Zero, it is suitable for developers of all skill levels and costs just $13. So though you might consider it for simple projects or to get some kind of hands-on. ROG 64 Media Board. The name is really different. The ROG 64 NVIDIA Media Board comes loaded with a 1.5 GHz ROG chip, RK3228, 64-bit quad-core A53 processor and a Mali 450 MP2 GPU. It ships in three configurations offering 1GB, 2GB and 4GB for 1600 MHz LPDDR3 RAM. The 1GB, 2GB and 4GB variants price ranging from $25, $35 and $45. The single board computer has the same form factor as Raspberry Pi 4, but the ROG chip is a little bit faster than the Broadcom processor found on the RPI model 3B+. At the same $35 price, you can get double the RAM, whereas 1GB model is just $10 cheaper. Where there's also a bootable eMMC socket alongside the more typical micro SD, so it's possible to add 16GB for $14, 32GB for $19 and 64GB for $31 directly on the board. Another key difference is that the Raspberry Pi alternative has also one less USB port, but on the 3 USB 3.0, you could theoretically with a USB hub. Now there is also HDMI 2.2 and gigabit Ethernet support. Unfortunately, the ROG 64 doesn't include wireless functionality, so you will have to add a USB dongle here. There's also no DSi and CSI camera, so there is no display and camera facility interface, but also there is a dedicated power jack and support 4K at 60 fps, so you will really good in working with graphical here. In terms of operating system support, there is initially Debian and Yocto Linux with more to follow, Android 7.1, Android 6.1, 16, and with Kodi 6.1 can also be run. Pocket Beagle. You may heard of the Beagle Bone or Beagle Board, which is a very distinct feature from and a very big competitor, which can become a big competitor of Raspberry Pi. The Beagle Pocket Beagle is a very small, tiny single board computer from BeagleBone, which just about qualifies as a Raspberry Pi alternative thanks to its micro SD slot and micro USB support. It's a very near about a coin size board. A tiny Titan is built around Octave system OSD 33258, 1 GHz ARM Cortex A8 with integrated 512 MB DDR3 RAM. It's about 56 by 35 mm big, so the same size, the equally minimalist Raspberry Pi Zero. The idea is that you can plug the Raspberry Pi alternative into a laptop like a USB key fob. From there, you can program the device using web browser that provides access to the Linux command line and text editor. The Pocket Beagle costs $37, which is substantially more than RPI Zero for similar space, and also the same price than a full-sized Raspberry Pi 3. So when the budget is a issue, you can easily switch to BeagleBone. Arduino Mega 2560. Hey, there, the first time Arduino is arriving with a microcomputer board. It is often get confused with Raspberry Pi due to their shared roots in the budget hardware and STEM education, but they are not in the same. An Arduino is based around microcontrollers, whereas a Raspberry Pi is based around a microprocessor connected on a board RAM and other features. While both boards can control electronics attached to their pin, the Pi is also capable of being used as a full desktop computer. Conversely, the Arduino is easier to use than building electronic prototypes and also to swap out for a new microcontroller in the final project. Indeed, the beating at the heart of vast majority of desktop 3D printers, the fused deposition modeling kind, and any rate, this is a thing called Rambo. This is not a banana wearing paragon of American military virtue, but an acronym of RIP RAP Arduino Compatible Motherboard, Rambo. So the question is, what is the right tool for your project? It is being used to the power something like a robot, a NARF gun turret, or a 3D printer, then the Arduino is suitable Raspberry Pi alternative. BBC Microbit. The BBC Microbit is a bare bones microcontroller with a pedigree that goes all the way back to the 1980s. It takes its name from the original BBC Micro, an 8-bit home computer that for many school kids in UK was their first very experience of computer programming. Continuing the educational legacy, the BBC Microbit is a $20 device with an ARM Cortex M0 processor, accelerometer, magnetometer sensor, Bluetooth, and USB connectivity, and a display consisting of 25 LEDs and 2 programmable buttons. The Raspberry Pi alternative can be powered by either USB or an external battery pack. In technical terms, it is nowhere near as the powerful of as versatile as other single board computers in the list, but as low cost, accessible introduction of to coding and other basic projects, the BBC Microbit is a fantastic Raspberry Pi alternative. Indeed, two can be paired to work together. Banana Pi M64. So you have heard about Raspberry Pi, and we are competing and we are finding the best competitor of Raspberry Pi. So here is the Banana Pi. It's a single board computer with quad core all winner A64, 1.2 GHz CPU, plus Mali 400MP2 GPU, 2GB RAM and 8GB eMMC. Inside the Raspberry Pi alternative, you can have 4K HDMI, MIPI DSI and MIPI CSI, as well as onboard wireless and gigabit Ethernet connections. The 92x60mm board also has a try of USB host port, a micro USB and a RPI compatible 40 pin connector. It currently retails for $60. So if you are really looking for some kind of better alternative of Raspberry Pi, you can find Banana Pi. ASUS Tinker Board S. So the major manufacturer of computer is now coming into the competition, and the place taken by ASUS is the ASUS Tinker Board S. The Tinker Board is a second iteration of single board computer by ASUS. Immediately obvious is that it has the exact same size, layout, feature set and 40 pin connector as a standard Raspberry Pi 3 model B+. That means the Tinker Board S can function as a drop-in replacement for any fruity computers you already have in circulation. But why would you want to that? That brings us to the second point with the concerns of the specs. While an Raspberry Pi 3 is substantially cheaper, the Tinker Board S has a faster, albeit still 32-bit processor, the ROG chip RK3288, which has 4X Cortex-A17 at 1.8 GHz. It has also more powerful Mali T760 GPU, 2GB RAM and a gigabit Ethernet instead of fast internet. The Raspberry Pi alternative also has 16GB of built-in eMMC memory and supports upscaled 4K x 330 fps playback. The other features include Wi-Fi, Bluetooth 4.0 and 4x USB 2.0 ports, plus micro USB and micro SD HDMI interfaces along with that. Oh, and something called Smart Audio Jack that provides SPDIF for digital audio rates up to 24-bit 192 kHz, but you can still hook up to the stereo you use. A growing community site has a forum and other resources to get you started. In addition of Tinker OS, a fork Debian, Linux and other images for Android and Armbian, plus emerging support for applications like RetroPie and Volmuno. But the better there is a catch, isn't there always? The Tinker Board has a suggested retail price of $89, though the order of the Tinker Board is only online. The older Tinker Board, which omits the 16GB eMMC, can be found for as low as $50. So there are the 7 different microcomputer boards I have discussed here. There are also so many boards available on the web, like Huawei, like Odroid. But the rating I've got and the unique features I've got, I decided to make video on that. Microcomputers are really handy to use. It is very fun to use and very easy to learn with. Thank you.